So you got yourself a TCL 5 Series Google TV and you want to get at the best picture settings. That is what I'm here to help you with today. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Caleb Dennison. And before I start clicking buttons to show you how to get the best settings on this TV, keep in mind, these are the best settings according to what I prefer. They may not necessarily be the best settings for you, but they are a great starting point. And from there, you can kind of tweak things to get them how you like it. Remember, the most important thing is getting the picture quality that you want. Also, a quick note before we get into this, this is for the Google TV version of the TCL 5 series, not the Roku version. The settings themselves and how you get to them are very different, so keep that in mind as well. Real quick though, I'm curious, do you find these settings videos helpful? Would you like us to continue to do them? Leave me a comment about that down below, and while you're down there, please consider liking and subscribing. That's a great way of letting us know if you actually do appreciate these videos. Now, let's get into it. All right, let's manage some settings. So there are a couple of different ways of getting to the settings for a TV. You can navigate over to your Google account in the upper right-hand corner, or you can just press the settings button on this TCL 5 Series remote to get to the main settings screens. Then you want to go down to display and sound and click on picture. Pretty easy so far. Now, straight out of the box, this TCL 5 Series TV is going to be in a low power mode. And while that may seem appealing, especially when it says optimized to save power, recommended for daily use, it's really the worst thing for your picture quality because you will not get the peak brightness that you want for SDR or HDR. Now, there's a smart HDR, which promises a powerful and vivid picture. And I actually, to be honest with you, I've not seen this before because this is my first TCL Google TV. But I can tell you right now that for most of what I'm gonna wanna watch, I'm gonna use the movie preset. Now that's gonna warm up the color temperature, maybe scale back some of the motion smoothing settings, we'll see. What I've noticed is that there's no standard mode here. You've got the very garish vivid, you've got low power, which we wanna get out of, and we've got smart HDR, which kinda sounds like what is the new standard mode. And then there's sports and game. This should automatically go into game mode when it sees a gaming device connected and you're actually going into a game. And I've noticed that it's warming up the picture quality a little bit. So looking like the game mode is gonna be almost as good as the movie mode, just in terms of picture accuracy. Well, once we're in the movie mode, we have adjustments for brightness and color saturation. And frankly, I don't think you're going to need to adjust either of those things. Let's pop into advanced settings and see what we've got. Brightness settings, we've already mentioned that it's at 80, and I'm gonna recommend you probably wanna keep that at 80 for standard dynamic range stuff. For HDR, it'll probably max itself out. Looks like we also have a contrast and a black level setting here. I am not 100% certain what this is gonna do, so we're gonna leave this at its default for now. In terms of dynamic contrast, actually, this is a processing-based contrast enhancer. It has nothing to do with the local dimming per se, so I'm not gonna recommend we turn that on. Black stretch, enhance the black of the picture for stronger contrast. That sounds like a stretch to me. Dynamic brightness, also another processing thing that's going to adjust the backlight according to the picture content. I'm not going to turn that on. Where I see local contrast, this is indeed the local dimming setting, and I'm having a hard time imagining a situation in which we would not want this to be high. In fact, just a cursory glance, I would want to go off or high. Low looks terrible. So let's not do that. Let's leave it on high. Again, the defaults are looking good here. Gamma at 2.2, which is where you want it for movie content. And wow, that looks like it's about it. That is the advanced settings. What I'm noticing here is nothing for motion. All right, next option is for color. I would not recommend you touch any of these unless you find a particularly warm setting to be a little off-putting. You could actually back it down a little bit without going all the way to the cool side, which I think looks like ice. That's not great. So if you're not into a truly warm picture, you can back this down a little bit. But notice that just the difference between the furthest warm setting and one back is pretty stinking dramatic. Maybe that's good for you though, I don't know. Again, this is all about finding the settings that you like the best. Dynamic color is turned on by default. And I am not sure why that is, but I don't see a reason to turn it off at this point. If it turns out that I don't like it, I'll mention it in the full review. Clarity, you guys know that I'm gonna come straight to this section and make sure that we don't have any artificial sharpness turned on. Digital noise reduction being at medium is probably fine. This will be good for low bit depth content. Noise reduction in general is turned off, that's fine. Gradation clear sounds like something that would reduce banding on a television. And if that's indeed the case, I would certainly want it to be on high. Motion settings, both turned off, which I am encouraged by because I would want that for a movie setting. Now, if you don't mind soap opera effect, you might want to turn these on. I'm not sure what Nature Cinema is going to do in the context of a TCL Google TV. We'll have to dig into that a little bit deeper. But again, I don't really want any artificial motion processing turned on for this TV. So I'm glad to see that that's the case. Now, under expert calibration, I do not recommend that you go messing around in here because for one thing, it's hard to understand exactly what the adjustments here do. When you're talking about 2-point white balance adjustment, a move on the red gain, for instance, is gonna have a dramatic effect on how green and blue are balanced out. And without actually being able to measure what you're doing, there's no way to know if you're actually doing damage or not. So I generally recommend that unless you have gear to measure or you're hiring a calibrator, stay out of this section. And the reason I don't show you what I will do with a 2-point white balance adjustment is because this TV will be different than the TV that you have at home, and it will not reveal the same results. So that's why we don't get into this section in these videos. And a lot of you ask about that, and I'm not gonna do it because it might mess up your TV more than it helps it. All right, so that is the basics on the settings. I mean, if you followed along, once we went to the movie mode, we pretty much left everything at its default. That takes care of the home screen. Now, let's see what happens when we start opening some apps. All right, so I pulled open YouTube and grabbed an SDR video. Any SDR video is fine. You can leave it running or you can press pause. That makes it a little bit easier to see the effect of your adjustments if it's paused like that. We'll go into the picture settings and look at that. We're in movie mode for SDR, which is great. Now, if I go in deeper and check things like motion, for instance, and it's still off, sure is, then I can probably trust that all of the other settings that I made have carried over from the home screen into the apps. Yep, sure enough, I left color temperature at -4. I'll move it to 5 now because that's where I really wanna be, but it carried over everything that we did earlier from the home screen. Now let's see what happens when we get into HDR for an app. All right, so we pulled up an HDR video as evidenced by the HDR10 tag up in the upper left-hand corner. Thank you very much, TCL. I like that kind of confirmation. And let's see where we landed for the picture settings. Now my hope is that because I chose movie for SDR, that maybe we're getting something similar for the HDR by default. And sure enough, we are in a movie HDR picture setting. Let's take a look at some of the advanced settings and see if anything significant has changed. Nope, dynamic contrast is still off, black stretch still off. Dynamic tone mapping is on, that's for HDR local contrast still at high. This looks good so far. Motion also turned off. You know what? Considering that these are kind of my preferences for a movie picture setting, I'm pretty happy so far. Let's see what happens when we go into Dolby Vision. All right, so we've pulled up a Dolby Vision, also Dolby Atmos title on Netflix, and we'll press pause. Really love those confirmations, although interestingly enough, once you get into the content, you're getting the Dolby Atmos confirmation, not the Dolby Vision confirmation. Anyway, let's go into the settings once again, and I'm betting we're gonna be in Dolby Vision Bright by default. Wow, things really slowed down here. But this is the first time that we've opened Netflix, so I'll give it a pass. Yep, sure enough, Dolby Vision Bright. You know, 9 times out of 10, Dolby Vision Bright is what I want, even when I'm in a darker room. I just like the punchier HDR highlights. Let's double check a few things. Contrast all the way up, just like we expect. Local contrast, look, all that digital processing stuff that we saw in the SDR and HDR, it's gone. Why? Dolby won't even allow it to be an option. That's one of the things I love about Dolby's process. They kind of take control of the experience. You know, they make it less likely that something's gonna get screwed up. Everything here is great. I would not need to adjust anything at this point outside of like the 2-point white balance for Dolby Vision. So that covers our apps. Let's see what happens when we get into an HDMI input. Okay, so I tuned into our UHD Blu-ray player. I've got the old Spears and Munsell disc in there. It is already in HDR because it's an HDR disc. We'll go into settings and see what happened. Display and sound, picture, and bust. It's in the low power mode. All right, so while going into the Google home screen affects the apps, so basically you just need to make your settings for SDR, HDR, and Dolby Vision. Over in the app zone, you're gonna have to go ahead and make a change for the HDMI inputs. I was hoping it would just kind of be copied over and save us a little bit of time. But at least we know now that we do need to go into our HDMI inputs and just make that setting. And really, it's looking more and more like all you really need to do is go with the movie setting if you want the most accurate picture. If you find yourself enjoying, you know, like a slightly cooler color temperature, but you don't want the motion smoothing settings to be on there, then like I said, just go into the advanced settings, go into color, and kind of back down the color temperature a little bit, you know, to each their own. So it's kind of good news that it's a reliable movie preset. Just kind of a bummer that you do have to go into your HDMI inputs and make those settings. And don't forget, you'll need to do the same thing. You'll want to play like an SDR Blu-ray or DVD, then play something with HDR. And if you have a Dolby Vision capable player, you'll want to make sure that you select either Dolby Vision Bright or Dolby Vision Dark to taste. All right, so let's address gaming. I've plugged in the Xbox Series X and powered it on. It's in HDMI 3 for this particular TV. And I'm a little concerned there because I see it's at 1080p 60. Why is that? Well, let's see what the Xbox has to say. We'll go into the Xbox's settings. There we go. And what we're looking for is the TV and display options and then 4K TV details. It looks like it does support 4K 60, not 4K 120, which we knew. It won't do 120 FPS. It says it doesn't support HDR 10 for gaming, which I know it actually does. It says that it doesn't support Dolby Vision for gaming. I wasn't 100% on that. All this looks really odd. So 4K is an option. I'm gonna go ahead and enable that and make sure that, yep, sure enough, we're at 4K 60. Why it didn't do that as default, I'm not sure, but I'm a little bit concerned. Oh, look at that. HDR is now enabled, Dolby Vision's now enabled. It's almost like they needed to talk a little bit more before, you know, things synced up. Interesting. Well, if you have a similar experience, you know, definitely check that out. Anyway, now let's get into our picture settings. And remember, everything I've done for HDMI so far has been around that movie mode. This is supposed to support a auto game mode. So let's see where we're at. Picture mode is in low power. Womp womp. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to game mode. Not sure why it isn't working. I did go and look for a CEC control option to maybe enable a little bit more communication between the devices. But right now, all I can say is that auto game mode is not working for the Xbox home screen. I'm gonna give the TV one more shot. We're gonna go into display and sound. I'm gonna put it back into, not low power mode, but I'm gonna put it into, we'll go into movie mode here. So we're out of that default low power mode. This is just the home screen for the Xbox. And you know, honestly, if I was gonna go into Netflix and play a movie, I wouldn't want it to be in game mode necessarily. But when I go into Forza Horizon 5, I do want it to go into game mode. So let's see what happens when we do that. All right, so Forza Horizon 5, after a relatively quick update, has loaded for us, and I noticed it went into HDR, which is a great start. So what HDR did it go into? We go into our picture settings, and it looks like it's still in movie mode. So the auto game mode is not yet working for us. And I'll be honest with you, you know, I don't really feel like I want to spend a ton of time going through settings to try and find out how to turn that on. Auto game mode, I mean, it's in the name. It should be automatic, and it's not. So I will talk to TCL. We will find out what's up with that, find out if there's a bug or if I'm missing a buried setting. But you know, I feel like most folks, they never get this deep into a TV's settings in the first place, right? And if I can't find it dealing with TVs all the time, albeit the first time I'm dealing with a Google TV platform on a TCL, who else is gonna ever get there? Will the auto game mode just never work for them? I don't know. But to find out, you'll have to come back for the full review, which I would encourage you to do because I think it's really important to find out just how much better the Google TV version of the 5 Series is than the Roku version. There you go. I hope this video has been helpful. And don't forget, these are my personal preferred settings. They're not necessarily the best settings for you, but I think it's a great starting point for you to start toying around and getting the best possible picture quality you can from your new TCL 5 Series Google TV. Thanks as always for watching, everyone. I really do appreciate it. Kind reminder to please like and subscribe if you found this video helpful. And here's two other videos that I think you'll like.